Welcome to USA Breaking News Today. Please subscribe and click notification box to get all breaking news alert.
Breaking news today, Russia vs USA, are we going to war with Russia? Will UK back Trump in World War III? Russia has threatened to retaliate if US missiles, vehicles and ships sent by President Trump target government forces in Syria. But will the UK go to war with Russia? And will Britain back the US in a potential World War III? This evening, the Russian UN ambassador urged the United States and its Western allies, including the UK, not to attack President Bashar al-Assad's forces in an escalating crisis over the alleged chemical attack in Syria. Vasily Nebenzia said his country's main priority in Syria was to avert the danger of war but could not rule out the possibility of one with the US. It comes as Western nations grow more defiant in their anti-Assad rhetoric, with France's President Emmanuel Macron saying he has proof that Syrian government forces were responsible for the alleged chemical attack in Douma, which killed up to 75 people. US officials have collated blood and urine samples testing positive for chlorine gas and a nerve agent, according to US network TV station NBC. President Trump told reporters today that decisions about possible US military action will be made fairly soon. Are we going to war with Russia? Will UK back USA in World War III? Downing Street said tonight that the cabinet had agreed that the use of chemical weapons in Syria must not go unchallenged, but did not confirm if the UK would back the US in war action. A number 10 statement said, "The Prime Minister said it was a shocking and barbaric act which killed up to 75 people, including children, in the most appalling and inhumane way." Cabinet agreed that the Assad regime has a track record of the use of chemical weapons and it is highly likely that the regime is responsible for Saturday's attack. The Prime Minister said it was a further example of the erosion of international law in relation to the use of chemical weapons, which was deeply concerning to us all. Following a discussion in which every member present made a contribution, Cabinet agreed it was vital that the use of chemical weapons did not go unchallenged. Prime Minister Theresa May earlier held a two-hour emergency meeting at No. 10. She is under pressure from opposition leaders, including Jeremy Corbyn, not to commit UK troops to military operation without parliamentary consent. Earlier, Mr. Trump appeared to backtrack on inflamed comments he tweeted on Monday that Russia should get ready. Today he tweeted, "Never said when an attack on Syria would take place. Could be very soon or not so soon at all. In any event, the United States, under my administration, has done a great job of ridding the region of ISIS. Where is our thank you, America?" However, he later told reporters ahead of meeting with lawmakers that a resolution could be happening fairly soon. He said, "We're having a number of meetings today, we'll see what happens. Now we have to make some decisions, so they'll be made fairly soon." U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis has told Congress he believes a chemical attack did take place in Syria and wants inspectors to move in as quickly as possible to retrieve evidence. Members of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, OPCW, will arrive in Douma, Syria, on Saturday to investigate the alleged use of chemical weapons there. Thanks for watch. Please share, like, comment this video and subscribe channel for latest news.